Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to create depth of field effect, which could be useful for creating stunning background on your website. This technique uses only CSS and can be done in just a few minutes. Let's check it out. So we'll need two separated images. First is background and another is object that closer to your eyes. In this case, I will use a rifle image captured from Call of Duty game. Next, I will create depth for both images. For the CSS, first let's set the background image. I will set the position to absolute. And set the image size a little bit larger than the viewport. If we don't do this, you'll see the white area around the edges when we apply the blur filter. Also add overflow hidden to the body to remove the scroll bar. Next, let's add the rifle. Similar to background, except we will place them at the bottom right. You will notice that I use percentage padding bottom instead of height. This is to preserve the deep aspect ratio if user resize the window. Then we will create a hover pseudo class for both depths to remove the blur filter. Also add 1 second transition. And this is the easiest way to do it with pure CSS method. But if it's okay for you to add a small JavaScript, then we can capture the mouse position and adjust the depth dynamically. So let's remove the blur filter and hover class. Then in the JavaScript, we'll set the focus point for each dip. I will set the focus point of the background to 50 pixels from top and 1000 pixels for the rifle. Then create a new style element and add it to the body. So if you want to add any CSS in the future, we can inject them to this element. Then we will add mouse move event listener. Inside, we will calculate the blur amount from the current mouse vertical position. The more cursor distance from the focus point, the more blur amount should be applied. And finally, we will apply the blur filter to the style element we just add. And to make it more realistic, we'll add a small scale transform to the background. And that's it for this tutorial. Hope you guys enjoy. If you love to see more development tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to our channel to stay tuned. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye.